Hey, in this video, we will delve deep into the world of NEO and will attempt to find a definitive answer to the question, what is NEO in crypto? Imagine that during your history class, you got an assignment to create a presentation about the Great Depression. The presentation will be graded, and it's your only chance to shine and secure a good evaluation for overall performance during the semester. The teacher told the whole class that students are invited to schedule a meeting with her to discuss presentations and make sure that they are created following all guidelines. So, as you're eager to get the highest evaluation, you schedule the meeting with the teacher. To your surprise, you're the only one who showed interest in having a consultation with the teacher in an attempt to nail the presentation. Ultimately, your thorough work with the teacher paid off, and you received the highest grade. While crypto is not included in history classes, this example showcases how two entities can work together toward a common goal and reach favorable outcomes. This is exactly what the team behind NEO is thinking by consulting with regulators to make sure that its services are regulatory compliant. Welcome to Crypto Finally Explained, the most crypto-friendly educational YouTube channel for actually learning crypto. Here, I finally explain crypto topics using simple animations, visual doodles, and real-life examples, so no matter if you're 5 or 75, you'll be able to understand it. In this video, by exploring the depths of what is NEO in crypto, we will pay great attention to the NEO smart economy and how it is applied to the NEO blockchain operations. Let's get to it! To get started with NEO, we need to open the first page of its history, which started in 2014. The project was founded by two men, Da Hongfei and Eric Zhang, who met at the blockchain conference in Shanghai. After several discussions, the two men launched a blockchain-based project called AntShares. A year after its launch, in 2015, the firm published its source code on GitHub, with the mainnet seeing daylight in October of 2016. However, due to brand conflicts and potential confusion with other entities, especially those linked with the Alibaba group, the company rebranded. In 2017, once known as AntShares, the company entered the crypto market under the name of NEO. If we look deeper into the history of NEO co-founders, the two men did not stop their ventures into the blockchain industry after founding NEO. A few years after launching the project, Hongfei and Zhang joined forces again to introduce OnChain. The new firm was created to offer blockchain solutions to local governments and other enterprises. If you want to know more about OnChain, leave a comment below and I will consider creating a dedicated video for this topic. Moving on. When NEO hit the market, it was the first Chinese blockchain to offer smart contracts for public use and the first company of such nature in China. Thus, it is not surprising that the project is often called the Ethereum of China or the Ethereum Killer. It is worth highlighting that the nicknames did not come from nowhere. NEO has several similarities with the Ethereum network. Among many others, there is the ability to create and manage decentralized applications, including decentralized exchanges. NEO was also considered the first blockchain-based company to use dual token model and the first to introduce the DBFT-style consensus mechanism. I'll tell you about that a bit later. So far in the video, we have learned how NEO appeared on the blockchain map, but the question of what is NEO in crypto still needs to be answered. So, what is it? Its definition states that NEO is an open-source, decentralized blockchain-based platform that aims to fully digitize assets and identities via smart contracts by creating a NEO smart economy. In addition, NEO strives to be a project that allows anyone to create decentralized applications, or dApps, and offer near-instant transactions. The idea of making NEO a smart economy platform is based on three foundational pillars: digital identity, digital assets, and smart contracts. The NEO network also offers other services, including an identity system, a decentralized file storage system, and an oracle system for feeding external information. Now that we know a bit more about how NEO was launched and what it strives to do in the blockchain sector, we can turn our attention to the mechanics behind the network. As I mentioned before, when it comes to the NEO smart economy, the platform allows users to digitize and automate the management of their assets on the blockchain. This functionality opens the door for users to record, buy, sell, or exchange any assets that they own. What is particularly interesting is that when registered on the blockchain, the assets receive a unique avatar that represents them in the blockchain ecosystem and gives them a digital identity. In a nutshell, this identity helps the platform protect all assets by the law. Moreover, these digital avatars also function together with microchip implants for animals and can help verify or find key information about digital asset owners. NEO has also made significant strides in the decentralized finance, or DeFi, sector. As NEO is a DeFi platform, it offers a handful of financial services, including yield farming, lending, and borrowing. By using NEO, crypto investors can delve into DeFi services without interference from intermediaries, increasing their financial inclusion or reducing costs. It is important to analyze how the NEO blockchain operates to fully grasp the extent of this project. In general, in the world of blockchains, there are two types of consensus mechanisms: proof of work and proof of stake. During the past few years, the debate regarding which one is better has been heating up. From an environmental perspective, proof of work requires way more electricity to validate nodes than proof of stake. However, POS has issues of its own. If you want to learn more about how POW and POS operate, check out my dedicated video, which compares both of these consensus mechanisms. When it comes to the NEO blockchain, it operates on a proof-of-stake delegated Byzantine Fault Tolerance Alternative, or DBFT. Quite a handful of words, right? This consensus mechanism links directly with NEO's regulatory compliance as it operates similarly to the country's governance system. The consensus mechanism has its own speakers, delegates, and citizens, ensuring that the network is fully functional. In terms of DBFT, citizens are considered to be NEO token holders, or ordinary nodes. In its governance system, bookkeeping nodes can be considered delegates, while the speaker is a randomly chosen delegate, aka a node. So, how does the NEO blockchain operate? NEO token holders vote for bookkeeping nodes. After these nodes are selected, one node is randomly chosen to act as the so-called speaker. Apart from the speaker, all nodes overview the transactions made on the network, keeping track and documenting them on the ledger. If you know anything about blockchains and how they operate, you may wonder how blocks get validated using this consensus mechanism. Well, the so-called speaker, or the random node, which was selected at the beginning of this process, must propose their block. Then, the speaker must send their block to all nodes to match their own blocks with the speaker's block to validate it. It's like in school. If the smart kid finds that the answer to a certain equation is 36 and tells that to other students, it is likely that other students will change their answer just because the smart kid told them so. No questions asked. To validate a block, at least 2/3 of the nodes need to agree on the block before it can be confirmed and added to the network. If less than 2/3 of the nodes agree on the block, a new speaker will be selected, and the whole process will start from scratch. What is interesting about how the NEO blockchain operates is that the team behind the project introduced the DBFT method in the first place. The consensus mechanism was constructed to support up to 10,000 transactions per second, offering low energy consumption and shutting down possibilities for major issues to arise. The transactions and agreements on the platform are executed through smart contracts. NEO-based smart contracts are tied to code, which ensures smart contract irreversibility, traceability, and transparency. However, the NEO blockchain wouldn't operate properly without its native coin. Thus, let's continue this NEO animated explainer by paying attention to the project's tokenomics. Similar to VeChain, a project that I've already covered on this channel, NEO has two native tokens, NEO and NEO Gas. So, what is NEO crypto? NEO is the project's first native coin, which serves as a governance and payment token. By holding NEO coins, community members can have a say on the platform's developments, including consensus node election, consensus plan of action adjustments, and pricing model modifications. It is worth highlighting that all NEO tokens were pre-mined during the Genesis event, meaning that its hard cap is 100 million. As of the second half of 2023, over 70% of tokens have already entered circulation. What is also interesting about NEO is that it's not divisible in fractions, meaning that the holder can own no less than one NEO. To answer your question of where to get NEO, the coin can be purchased on major crypto exchanges like Binance and KuCoin. But what about Gas? The second NEO DeFi native token is earned simply by staking NEO tokens and participating in NEO's consensus mechanism process. In terms of Gas use cases, the coin is mainly used to cover transaction fees and smart contract execution on the network. Opposite to its counterpart, the token can be divided into very small fractions. It is also worth highlighting that Gas tokens are issued every time a new block is approved. Before concluding this video, it is worth mentioning a significant event that changed the NEO ecosystem, arguably for the better. In August of 2021, NEO was upgraded to its third version, with the old ecosystem starting to be called NEO Legacy, and the new network getting the name NEO 3.0, or N3. According to the NEO team, the main purpose of the upgrade was to improve the development experience and make creating dApps easier for new developers. Moreover, the upgrade enhanced the network's governance and economic model by adding new features and a highly modular architecture. Certain new features, however, were not backwards compatible with NEO Legacy when the new upgrade launched. Therefore, N3 launched a new Genesis block. The term Genesis block refers to the first block recorded on a blockchain network. Following this event, users were urged to transfer their NEO and Gas tokens to the N3 blockchain. The migration was generally simple. Investors simply created a new address on the N3 blockchain and moved their tokens at a 1-to-1 ratio from NEO Legacy. As we reach the end of this video, hopefully the concept of what is NEO in crypto is as clear as day. However, before going our own ways, let's review what we learned about the NEO smart economy. As the so-called Ethereum of China, NEO aims to create a smart economy by fully digitizing assets and identities via smart contracts. Moreover, NEO strives to help crypto enthusiasts create decentralized applications and offer near-instant transactions. The NEO blockchain operates using the proof-of-stake delegated Byzantine Fault Tolerance Alternative, or DBFT, and has two native coins, NEO and Gas. The network's first native coin is used for governance and payment purposes. On the other hand, the gas token, as the name suggests, is used to cover transaction fees. Thank you so much for watching this video on the NEO project. I hope that it has helped you learn something new about the Web3 world and NEO in particular. If you like this animated explainer, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment below, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.